Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. I am Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner and advanced certified QuickBooks Pro Advisor of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consultant. I am also a financial controller serving nonprofits and service-based businesses by helping them to increase profitability one mission at a time. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to create a vendor in QuickBooks Online. Some guidelines to keep in mind when creating vendors and entering expenses in QuickBooks Online are: number one, don't create a vendor for each one-time expense, such as restaurants or gas stations or parking lots or parking meters. Use one generic name for all of your restaurants. Use one generic name for all of your gas stations. Use one generic name for all of your parking meters and parking lots, and then use the memo and description field to add the actual vendor's name when entering the transaction in QuickBooks Online. When creating a vendor in QuickBooks Online, enter all of their contact details, such as their billing address, email address, phone number, website, billing account number, billing terms, and their tax information if they are a service vendor that is subject to IRS definition of a contractor for 1099 purposes. I also recommend using the attachment section to add copies of contracts and W-9 forms. Use the notes section for any special notes that you want to remember for that vendor. If you have employees that you do reimburse, add a V to the ending of their last name in the vendor center to differentiate them from the employee list center. And then the final tip that I have is make sure you add a vendor name to all expense transactions that you record inside of QuickBooks Online. Never leave the vendor name field blank. Now that you understand the guidelines for creating a vendor and recording expenses in QuickBooks Online, let's switch to QuickBooks Online to begin the demo. This is my QuickBooks dashboard. To access the vendors list, click on the Expenses tab at the left navigation bar. Then select the Vendors tab. The colored section that you're seeing at the top of my screen is known as the Money Bar. The Money Bar shows you the purchase order you have created, overdue bills, and bills that you have recently paid in QuickBooks Online. Clicking on any one of these boxes will open up a filtered list. So if you click on the overdue bills box, it will show you vendors that have open bills inside of the system. To create a new vendor, click the green New Vendor button at the top right of the screen. QuickBooks will open the vendor entry screen. Here you can add a vendor's full contact details using a physical copy of an existing bill or a prior bill. I am going to add my firm as a new vendor by filling out all of the open fields. One cool thing about QuickBooks Online is that when you start typing a vendor's name in the system, it will try to look up their information in the Duns & Bradstreet business database and auto-populate all of the contact information fields for you. Since I exist in the database, QuickBooks will auto-populate my firm's information. Just pay attention to the address field. Make sure the address field matches the information on your prior bill. Don't want to end up sending a check to the wrong bill and address. I am going to fill in all of the missing information that the system did not auto-populate. You also want to make sure the information you enter here for a service-based business, especially a 1099 contractor, matches the completed W-9 form. You can also print a check with a different name than the one that is displayed. I like my clients to make their checks payable to my firm's name instead of my personal name. I will uncheck the print check box and select my firm's name or re-enter it. If you have a designated account number on your bills and billing terms from your vendors, enter them in the account number and the billing term fields. I don't have any one of those, so I will leave those two fields blank. Now, the business ID number field should be used to record a social security number or a federal identification number from a completed W-9 form. This is the form that you would typically request your service-based vendors or contractors to complete when they engage with your organization. I highly recommend collecting a W-9 form from all of your service-based businesses that meets the IRS definition of a contractor before you make the first payment to them. This will save you the hassle of having to chase people down at the end of the year. It will also prevent you from having to withhold 24% of their income as taxes to remit back to the IRS at the end of the year as well. Since I am an independent contractor, I will enter my federal identification number here and also check the box that says track payments for 1099. Checking this box allows me to be able to run a 1099 transactions detail report at the end of the year, prepare 1099s inside of QuickBooks Online, or to export that report and provide to a CPA or third-party payroll provider to prepare 1099s for me. Now, I like to use the notes fields to document things like summary of contract terms or, you know, anything else that is special that does not fit any of the other fields that we mentioned before. In addition to that, I like to also drag a copy of a completed W-9 form into the attachment section. So when I work with nonprofits and if I'm setting up their vendors in their system, I usually add like a vendor contract to the attachment section or like a W-9 form or any special thing that my nonprofit clients need to remember about that particular vendor, such as, oh, this is a one-year contract, or hey, they need to renew the contract. Renewal date is a, you know, different dates and stuff like that. So anything special, you can add the existing contract in the attachment fields, or you can add anything special inside of the notes field. Review everything you just entered to make sure it matches a copy of your bill. Then click save to exit the vendor entry screen. In the vendors center, you can scroll down to find my firm's name that we just added, or you can use the search bar at the top to search for it. That is a quick and easy tutorial on how to create a vendor inside of QuickBooks Online.